Toastmaster, dear club members, and dear guests, I wish I had this presentation at least 3 weeks ago, because the best teams are already out, I mean Polish and Ukrainian team, so it's late, but I think not too late, because we still have 3 very important games, 2 semi-finals and 1 big final in Kiev. And I'm sure we will have, and we can have, a lot of exciting moments watching that. So today, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to share with you and tell you something, give example how you can behave on a football stadium if you are lucky to get tickets, or in fan zone, we have a very big fan zone in Warsaw, very nice, or in every place where you want to do it, in pub or even at home. And first thing to be a football fan, football supporter, is your outfit, how you look. So right now I don't look like really football supporter, so I need something that really will prove that I am one. And you have to show other people that you are connected with the team and you wear something at least in the colors of your team. That's very important, but that's not everything. There are also other important elements. You can also paint your face to show how dedicated you are. Okay. Give me a minute, sorry. Okay, you can paint your face like this. Okay, yeah, let's say it's okay. And then you need also one very important item, which I like personally the most, this. I'm sure you know what is it. This is something that we very know here in this part of the world. We use it when it's cold to cover our necks. But this is something also that is very important for every football player. Actually, they can't even imagine living without it, because they use it in many ways. I will show you 3 ways, 3 moves that I really like with scarf. So the first move, I call for this presentation a national anthem or we are the champions move. And you can do it very simply when you raise your scarf above your head and then you can sing the national anthem. You can look right, left, and in front, and you can be proud. You can also sing We Are the Champions. You don't have to be champions, but the impression is very good. But doing that, you have to be very careful, because sometimes happens that you raise it it's upside down. So if you are in the crowd, it's not a problem, but if you are alone, if you are a celebrity, it's very embarrassing when they make a photo of you. So that was one move. And the second move I also really like is you have to take the scarf, fold it like this, hold it here, and then raise above your head and turning around. It's actually not really important if you turn it clockwise or counterwise. Important is that you do it along with other people in your area. And you have to be careful because other people also will do it, and then you should avoid hitting other people's scarves. And also, you can jump doing that a lot of directions, and you can sing. I will not sing today because it's not the object for the project, but you can think of a lot of songs. And the third move that is also important, I think, is connected with a very nice thing on the stadium. Everyone knows it, I think. It is so-called Mexican wave. Mm-hmm. In the US they call it only wave, not Mexican, I don't know why. But we here call it Mexican wave, and I don't think I should explain how it works. But you can have a lot of fun with a scarf by Mexican wave. So Mexican wave work like this, that you can expect it from left and from the right. You have to prepare. Mm-hmm. you get a little bit down, or you can sit if you are on the stadium, and then you can expect the wave coming. You can even make some sounds like you can even start to step, and then when the wave is coming, you can say whoa! And that's how it works. It's very energetic and powerful. Even right now, I'm not in the stadium, but I feel it. I don't know what is your impression, but I'm really, I have a lot of power right now. And that's how it works. So only three simple moves that I really like, but there are unlimited ways how you can support your team, how you can behave on stadium. I know that in the past, before Euro 2012, we had a lot of stories about hooligans, but we had a little this experiences during the group round. But right now, you have very nice football atmosphere almost everywhere, on the street, in fan zone, or in stadiums. I was lucky, and I will see the last game in Warsaw, Germany against Italy. So I will use my moves that I showed you today. And I would like to leave you with the impression that football supporter is not a bad guy. It's someone who likes football, someone who is happy, someone who wants to share with other people his feelings. And if you have possibility to go to a football game, not especially this tournament, but afterwards, you should go. Thank you very much.